Nikki Dominique, and I'm rocking out with Chi-Town.
Chi-Town
Urban Radio,
Urban Radio.
Good, it's your girl KT
Lace.
I'm rocking with DJ
Malone.
Chi-Town Urban Radio.
Hey guys, this is Attila, ATTXLA, because X marks the spot all day, every day. And you are watching or listening to, depending on what you're doing, Chi-Town Urban Radio. Thank you.
Chi-Town Urban Radio.
Chi-Town Urban Radio.
You jamming to Chi-Town Urban Radio.
Hey, this is Charlie, and I'm rocking with Chi-Town Urban Radio.
Beauty.
Let's go, Malone. Yeah, that's right. You just locked into one of the hottest shows in the Midwest. This is Chi-Town Urban Radio, baby, where we play the hottest music and discuss the hottest topics.
If I have an opinion about something, why should I have to say I'm sorry about it? Right. That's my true opinion.
Right, exactly.
So
just because you don't agree, we agree to disagree.
Nobody does it.
Yo, you never know what's going to happen next. So log on to ChiTownUrbanRadio.com and make sure you follow us on Instagram at Chi-Town Urban Radio. Go ahead and hit us up on that call-in number. 312-985-7834. You got all that? Now let's go ahead and bring in our host, Chi-Town Urban Radio. Please welcome Ebony, Kiara, and DJ Malone. They ready, baby. Let's go.
I'm all the way up.
Let's go, Malone.
Yo, hold on. Let me turn myself up. There we go. Yo, it's the one and only DJ Malone, man. I welcome you, Chi-Town Urban Radio. Now, this is our first time back since Houston, Texas. Did you guys miss me? Ebony Care is on her way. She had to do this thing, I guess, the wild and out situation. She's doing that and the casting call. So, big opportunity for anybody out there who's trying to get her, man. But we do got a special guest into the building. And, you know, I love bringing her around because she's real. She keeps it funky with me. Let's bring her in right now, man. We got Charlie. What's going on? How you doing, man?
I'm doing good, darling. How you doing?
Man, welcome back.
Glad to be here.
Hey, I'm glad that you're here. I'm glad that you're here, though, man. So, what's been going on since the last time that we talked?
You know, just been working, just grinding, doing what I gotta do.
Real,
staying,
man.
Staying on my toes.
That's what it is. If anybody who didn't know you, tell the people who you are and what you do.
I am a Chicago model, okay. Glamour model, nudie model, lots of kind of different modeling.
Anything with modeling that you've done.
Yeah,
that's
much.
What it is. That's what
pretty
it is, much. Though, man. You know, I was going to talk about the situation with Remy Ma and Nikki, and we're going to talk about that in a little bit, but I want to get your opinion, because when I went to Texas, there was abundance of people who really liked Trump. And it tripped me out because, like, I understand it's Texas.
It's them hardcore Americans.
I understand that it's Texas. But then it really gets me thinking, where the hell are we in this America as a country? Like, if we vote this guy in, I don't know. I just don't agree. What's your thoughts on the whole situation and how it came about?
Well, actually, I don't really have a dog in that race. I didn't think either one of them should have been running the country. So I can't really give too much of an opinion about it because I didn't vote.
Yeah.
You know.
Oh, well, I mean, I didn't vote either.
I just kind of like, you know, hang out on the sidelines.
I think something's going to happen. I think China and Russia is going to come together. And you know what? China said, look, you guys owe us money anyway, so we're coming in there. And we're going to take over.
Yeah, I think another war is definitely inevitable at this point.
That's real. I think it is,
gotta
too.
Gotta make
though.
That money.
Hey,
people. We's in debt.
Yeah, we. Mm-hmm. But how do we get out of debt, though? That's the big question.
I don't know if I could say that on the radio. We'd have to come down on the government. That's what we'd have to do.
Yeah.
We'd all have to just come on down.
Yeah. Speaking of government, I went to Michael Center. Trey G is in the building. I went to Michael Center, and I was getting some stuff for like DJing. I got some photography stuff. And when I got there, they were like, "Well, you got to pay us $10 per bag."
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, "For what? I just bought something. He didn't give me a bag." So I'm thinking, well, can I get a bag, please? He was like, no. I was like, why not? He was like, well, you got to pay for a bag.
Uh-huh.
What I got to pay for a bag for if I just bought the stuff? No, it's 10 cents per bag now. So Chicago passed the law, I think on February 1st, that now you got to pay for the paper bag.
Yep, I've experienced that myself.
Did that trip you out when it first happened?
Oh yeah, for sure. But it doesn't surprise me. We're constantly being extorted. I mean, for every little thing.
Yeah.
You know, driving privileges, walking privileges, talking privileges. It's all.
So, but I think Chicago, maybe just because I'm from Chicago, but they get you for every little.
Mm-hmm. It's panic. Chicago. That's what we're known for here.
I'm pretty sure they get that in L.A. and New York.
Yeah.
You've been traveling at all lately?
I have, actually. I've been traveling locally in the Midwest. It's kind of, okay. You know, it's a slow season, but I just kind of stick around home, and then I'll probably be venturing out in the spring.
Okay. Yeah. Any big plans for the summertime?
I have a few trips planned. Greece might possibly be one trip. We might head out down there to Maldives, possibly shoot.
Okay.
There's also the Jamaica trip again in September. I got a Baltimore trip in June, and just a few other things here and there. I'm usually traveling a lot, so it's California, Florida, New York, yada yada yada. It's kind of just circulates through the year.
And last time I asked you what was your favorite place to go to, what's your favorite place to go to in the U.S.?
In the U.S., definitely Colorado, for sure. It's real quiet, peaceful.
In the mountains.
Mm-hmm. It's a little expensive, though, but I guess what's not these days, you know what I mean?
Yeah, that's real.
Mm-hmm.
Hey.
But yeah, it's a nice outlet.
Okay.
Definitely a nice outlet.
I've been to Colorado one time when I was little. Mm-hmm.
You got to go deep in the mountains. You got to get in there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I don't remember it. Like, some places I know that I've been because my people took me, but it's like I don't remember it, so... As an adult, maybe I'll probably go back to Colorado, you know, just to check it out. So, it hasn't been feeling more of a winter.
No, it's actually, I thought it was spring about a week ago.
It was like, what, 71 degrees?
Yeah.
Because I was still in Texas, and I was coming back to Chicago. And they were like, man, it's hot as hell here, Jones. Mm-hmm. I'm like, well, what's the temperature? 71. 71 in February.
Yeah, I actually left Chicago and then drove out to Milwaukee. And by the time I left Milwaukee, it was snowing. So I went from 70 degrees clothes packed to 30 degrees below.
That's crazy, man.
Yeah, it was pretty wild.
This has been probably the mildest winter that we ever had. Like,
yeah, it takes a lot out of you, too, you know?
Yeah.
With the weather change and just the that humidity in the air, you know.
Well, everybody's been sick though.
Yeah,
everybody.
That's all it takes is that drastic temperature change. You know, that's what culminates diseases and germs and funky.
Yeah, that's real
stuff.
Though, man. Hey,
respiratory infections and whatnot.
Hey, I tell people. Well, let me ask you this: do you believe in the flu shot? Because I get it both ways. Because people tell me to go get the flu shot, but some people tell me not to get it.
I think maybe if, you know, like children and the elderly should get those things. But I think if you're young and healthy, I don't think that you should get the flu shot. I think you should just maintain good levels in your body of certain things that you personally need.
Real.
And then, you know, just try your best not to get sick and stay away from people who are sick. Keep your hands washed.
And bring hand sanitizer everywhere.
But I've read up about a lot of the flu shots, and there's a lot of shady stuff in the actual ingredients. That's like stuff like laundry detergent and stuff like that.
Wow.
So I don't think you'd want to be injecting things like that. But
yeah.
if you do, I would suggest researching exactly what's in it, because you don't know what you're getting. You might end up getting sick, you know?
And you know, it opens you up. You know
right.
what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like
it
does. If you have a low immune system, it opens
yeah,
you
if
real.
You already have a low immune system and you take something like that, that could be like detrimental for weeks, you know what I mean? There goes work, there goes everything that you need to do. So it's better to just take care of your body before the problem, you know, before that kind of stuff comes up so that you're strong enough to fight it off.
Yeah, that's real though, man. Mm-hmm. But you stay fit, and you know, we mm-hmm. just talked about health. How do you stay fit? Like,
I'm
know?
Really active. Like, I'm very kind of like high strung, high functioning type person. So okay. I always have to be moving. Like, I can't really sit still for too yeah. long. Like, I can't be in front of a TV or a computer too long. Like, I'm yeah. always shaking and moving, you know.
What's your workout regimens like? Because I know you've been working out.
I do a lot of running, actually. Okay. I played soccer when I was in high school. Okay. So that's kind of what gave me all the curves, you
yeah,
know.
Yeah.
And I just kind of stuck with running, even though I'm getting, you know, as I'm getting older, it's more impact on my knees and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But I just do, you know, every day, any day things, if you're moving around and taking, you know, the stairs instead of the elevator.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? It does pay off. And then, of course, what you're eating, your portions, how many times you're eating a day.
Real.
And you do need to get, you know, certain things. You need to get certain things that, you know, your proteins and all them other iron, all your fun stuff.
Oh, yeah, man. I think we need to talk about that because I think people just pollute themselves. I mean, we got some good food in Chicago. So
yeah, we do, but you know what? It's like there isn't very many healthy alternatives unless you've got the money to spend on it. You know what
real,
I mean?
Real.
Unfortunately, it's like it's easier to go and get something cheap when you're working and you got 15 minutes to go get food and
exactly.
5 minutes to eat it. You know what I mean? So you really got to put in a lot of effort to make conscious. You can't have people making decisions for you and making your food for you
because
you're. You know.
Hey, that's what it is, though, man.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, man, we're here with Charlie Mancini, man. Now, I asked you before, and I don't remember, and you got to excuse me. Where did that name come from, Charlie Mancini?
It was just kind of something I picked. It has Mancini is an actual town in Chicago, and Charlie, I just couldn't... I just needed an alias name,
yeah.
and I wanted it... I didn't want it to be extremely feminine and, like...
Yeah.
In your face, stripper, Bambi, pixie, whatever, I don't know. I just kind of like the more masculine
yeah,
kind of
yeah.
thing.
Okay.
And it just kind of fit, I don't know.
Okay, well, that's what mm-hmm. it is.
I was probably stoned, you know, playing on the
no
computer.
Telling.
I was like, yeah, hey, that's a good idea.
You know what, though? Ain't no telling
it's backfired, though, actually, because I've gotten asked to shoot weird things because of my name. And it's always like, I actually had somebody ask me one time, they wanted me to shave these girls' heads on film and then do like some weird Charles Manson like skit, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I was just like, yeah, no, I don't think that would be a good idea.
Hey.
That's all I need, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
God forbid I ever do something bad in my life and that'll come back to me. Talk about I'm a cult leader and I got
bros
shaving their heads.
Damn. That's
selling
a real
their bro. Hair on the black market.
Hey. But it's crazy now because people are we'll probably more come into it, but everything's just so politically correct now.
It is. And I think the media has a lot to do with that. You know, I think that if we weren't talking about this stuff as much as we are and putting such emphasis and always being butthurt over everything, I think that it wouldn't be so big of an issue. You
yeah.
know, it doesn't seem to me like people don't get along and people aren't respectful of other people. It's to the point where people are so afraid to be disrespectful to one another that everybody just doesn't even, they close themselves off. And then, you know, then what happens? And we're all going to be...
Well, see, that's my thing about with the racism thing.
Mm-hmm.
Not everybody's a racist.
Well, right. You know what I mean? It's like... that's so beyond me. Like, I never knew that in my generation. You know what I mean? I know what's there. I'm aware of history and everything else like that. You know what I mean? Like, my ancestors have a terrible track record. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
So,
yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
But, yeah. I think it's just... I think the media really fuels it. And they get these people worked up. I think the younger minds are kind of like, they're looking for somebody to come and save them. And you got these people that are pumping money into these protests and all these other things and getting these people fired up. And they're fighting for the wrong reasons. Like, we should be working together, not working apart.
Exactly.
Because, you know, it's like, what's the expression? A house divided will never stand.
No.
You know what I mean? And it's like, it's us or them. and there's more of us than there are of them. Exactly. So they kind of keep us apart so that we don't talk to one another and say, holy shit, they're doing this to you because this is what's happening to me, you know?
Yeah, that's what it is.
Is they just want people to feud so that people are afraid to actually communicate about what's really going on and what really needs to change in this country.
Yeah. Hey, man, when we come right back, man, we're going to keep on talking to Charlie Mancini, man. We're here. The call-in number, 312-985-7834. Ebony Care is on her way. I know you guys, they love Ebony here, man. They love her. And, you know, that's...
Yeah, I was like, where is she at?
Everybody, every time, where Ebony at, man? But she's on her way, man. We're going to come right back. We got this new track by Travis Scott, Kendrick Lamar, called Goosebumps, right here on Sci-Town Number Radio. Tell your pastors, your sisters, your brothers. Tell everybody. We're going to come right back. Back, it's your boy DJ Malone. Let go.
Let's go, Malone.
I get those goosebumps every time you come around, yeah. You ease my mind, you make everything feel fine. Worry about those.
What's up, Chicago? It's your girl, Ebony Kiero.
We back. What it do?
What's going on, man?
Nothing much. You the one half the life. You've been gone forever.
Man, look, I'm gonna tell you like this. They kept me in Houston forever. I was happy though. I'm happy that they did it. You know, I wasn't, you know, not mad at all. But we got a special guest into the building. Charlie, man, what's going on? Welcome back, man. Welcome back.
Welcome to the new studio.
This is your first time being at the new studio. Mm-hmm. So, before we left, we were talking about politics and different stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Ebony, and me and you, we talked about this heavily before. Do you think we live in a day of age where you can't say anything anymore? Like, you can't truly tell somebody how you feel without them thinking you're a racist, you're gonna get sued?
I mean, you can say what you want. I mean, everyone can say what they want, but I more so think people tiptoe over a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
Like, they're not, it's like they're trying to be blunt, but they're not really saying exactly to the T what they want to say. But people still say what they want, no matter what others may think. But you still have the right to say whatever you want, whether it's a race thing, whether it's, you know, whatever. It doesn't matter. Politics, religion, all of that. You can say whatever you want. You're a human being. Everyone is entitled to their opinion.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I just feel like remember we had talked about this plenty of times. If my opinion doesn't match your opinion, then it all else fails. You're not the person who I really thought you were. Like, people like feel like we can't agree to disagree anymore.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So that's my whole thing. Like, you know, if like me and you are not always gonna see eye to eye on things. And that's okay. But now it's like people make it seem like you didn't believe that?
Right.
Who really are you?
What? Because people have too many feelings. That's the problem. It's they have too many feelings about things that are really irrelevant at the end of the day. You know what I mean? It's how you are as a person. Are you a good person?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Is your intent? Is your opinion? You know, I've noticed that, like, sometimes people, you'll see people do, you know, things that might not be good for their life, and sometimes people might try to point that out, and it's like other people will encourage the bad behavior so that they can watch the SHIT show. And it's like, sometimes I think it's almost love when you try to say, hey, you're looking like an a-hole, or you know, this might be a better whatever for you. But people can't take constructive criticism anymore.
No, they can't.
They definitely can't.
They can't, man.
Sometimes it's good intent, you know, and sometimes it's not.
Well, see, I grew up in the era where, like, there was, like, not everybody got a trophy. There was a first, second, third place winner. If you didn't make that, then you just wasn't good enough at that time.
That's the problem, too, is, the younger generations have been coddled their whole lives. You know, they're, like you said, everybody got a ribbon, so there's no room for competition. It's like, why am I going to bust my rear end if everybody gets the same thing that I do if I win, you know?
That
makes people, it kind of builds them up in the wrong kind of character, you know? It doesn't give anybody incentive to do anything. Okay. So you got a lot of people that are just, I think they get defensive because they have their own insecurities that
they don't quite understand.
Yeah.
So they'll just parrot, you know, the media or whatever's trendy at the moment. And I think that's why we have most of the mess that we have, because people don't have anything better to do with themselves.
Yeah, that's what it is, though.
And I actually do think that's why politics went the way it went and we got Donald Trump as the president. People, right. The SHIT show, they were you know, laughing, mm-hmm. thinking it was funny, and yeah. no one was really doing research on what was about to happen. And look, bam, Donald exactly. Trump is the president, yeah. and everybody's like, whoa, yeah, we didn't believe that was going to happen. Yeah, it did. Mm-hmm. And you should have been paying attention. So, right. you know.
Well, I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen. I know that, like, we talked about this before. Something's going to happen. I think he's going to get assassinated.
That's a possibility. I mean,
strong possibility.
He said a lot of things that, like, you know, there should have been handlers in place to keep that guy's mouth shut if he was running as a political figure. You know what I mean? So
yeah.
I think a lot of the things that he did was intentional to start a lot of this. You know what I mean? I think he's the start of the next wave of
racist
effery. You know what I
mean? That too.
Yeah, that's good. We're going to see a lot of that in the upcoming years.
Right.
Ebony, man. So, we talked about this right before we got on air. The Nicki Minaj,
ooh.
Remy situation.
Now, I got topics for days. We're going to be here all day with my topics. But, okay, Nicki and Rem. I don't have neither one. I do like both artists.
Okay.
And with Remy had being locked up for a minute. I think she was locked up for like maybe 7 years or so. Six. She got out going ham, so I give her that. So when she got out, it was nonstop work. And they've been, her and Fat Joe have been dropping hits since then. So,
yeah,
I mean, that's no issue. So I just think, I do believe Nicki should go ahead and hurry up and drop a track. But I will.
She's not dropping the track.
Which I could care less if she does. I mean, there's not a lot of female rappers as it is. And I don't think, who really cares about rap beef at this point? Is she the queen of rap? I don't know. But I do think she's more mainstream rap. And a lot of people are like, she's no battle rapper, which I could see. You know, she has become a mainstream rapper. I remember when she used to, I think she battle rap like when she was with Gucci, first came out, her bars were really strong. I don't know if she had a ghostwriter. I'm not gonna even speak on that. Who cares? But I do think she's a mainstream rapper, and which she went pop and she appealed to everyone instead of just where I think Remy is coming from, like just appealing to a certain like audience. Yeah. So and I actually read yesterday that they actually said that song with Nicki and Gucci, she wasn't even talking about Remy, so maybe Remy misfired. So, but I don't know. We don't know. They said she was talking about Azalea Banks, but who knows?
Here's my thing. Everything that Remy said, we already knew. It's already been said. She didn't, probably not bluntly like she did it, but it's already been said about her and Meek.
Drake.
The only thing that really caught me was Ebro. That's the only thing that caught me. I really thought Ebro. I'm like, no, Ebro. He got going on. But you know,
Flo wasn't all that great. Everybody just be so consumed with kind of what's going on and not really critiquing what is actually going on.
Her flow was not on point.
The lyrics, okay, but the flow and the beat, it was just all kind of it was all over the place for me. And I'm like, if you really enjoy music and you really listen, you were listening to what she was saying, but you really weren't listening to how it was like being come across with the beat, and you have to really listen to everything. That's how I critique music. When I listen to albums, I listen to something, okay, is the beat on point? Is your lyrics on point? Is it going to reach my soul? Or like, is it going to, you know, you have to really have everything in the play when you're listening to something. I'm listening, I'm just like, okay, yeah. All right, that went hard. It's like some stuff she was saying, I was like, woo, you know, woo. But I'm like, her flow ain't that great. And even in that Nicki and Gucci song, that song ain't that great. And Nicki bars weren't that great either.
Exactly.
So it's just like, I don't know.
I
really would like her to drop a diss track. That'd be great.
You know what throws me off, and I'm telling all the millennials this. This is how it used to be on the regular. Like, you know, because, you know, some, I was watching reactions of how, like, you know, 50 Cent used to be, the Ja Rules, the Lil Wayne's. Then the millennials, they're going like, wow, this is dope. This is the greatest thing ever. No, this has been like this. What are you talking about, sir?
I heard Nas actually, when they, like, Nas was beefing, I don't know who he was beefing with at the time.
Jay-Z?
Yeah, they said he actually didn't drop his diss track 7 years later. So who knows? We may not really get one from Nicki. And like I said, I could actually care less. I would really like it to happen because I really want to know what she got. Maybe she could care less either. I mean, there's a woman. I'm like, I don't know if she's like this, but I mean, I'm like, okay, she dropped the diss track. Okay, whatever. I'm going to continue working. She kept bringing up, you know, money and track, like your album sales and all that. I'm like, well, I guess that kind of does matter. I don't care what anybody says, whether you come in lyrics as far as or not. It does matter how much you're selling is going to matter. But like I said, Remy had just got out of jail, so I mean, her album sales and the way she's coming up ain't gonna be where Nicki is, because Nicki's been in the game for a minute. So.
Yeah. Well, do you want to say something? Go ahead.
I just love Papoose and Remy Ma's relationship.
I do.
Oh God.
I do. Right. I agree.
I honestly study, like, now I'm studying Papoose, like everything about Papoose. Like, he loves women.
He is. He's everything.
Take care of Remy Ma, like,
he holds it down.
He holds it down, like, you know what I'm saying? And with everything, like, he has her back, you know what I'm saying? Like, no matter what. Like, Ebro tried to say something about the whole situation, like, and he even, like, butted in, like, hold on, bro, you know, you just called me, and, you know, like, it's just crazy, but I just got mad respect for Remy Ma, because she keep it 100, and she been keeping it 100 for years.
Real.
And Nicki Minaj, I'm sorry.
She got some...
She's sellout.
It's nothing Nicki Minaj can say right now.
Buy my perfume.
Hey, that's
like
what
I
it
said,
is.
She's a mainstream artist now, which I think that was, I think that's honestly what you have to do in the end. I don't know if I necessarily be a sellout, but I think that's in this industry is what you have to do. You can't, it's not about just albums anymore. It's not because who's even really buying albums, right?
You're putting on shows that concerts, cost money.
You need,
and the performers pay for a majority of that stuff. It comes out of their money.
It's entertainment. You know what I mean? Like, if you were just doing concerts and music,
but look
what
at Chance.
She's got to cover her rear end.
If you look at Chance the Rapper, Chance was a person who basically just did only online and made Grammys on just
shout out
online.
To man, that was the most amazing to watch him win a Grammy. I definitely thought that was amazing for Chicago. That was amazing. Now, Chance is a different story, I would say.
He never
signed to any. Right. I just feel like that's a once in a lifetime thing. He never signed with anybody. All these artists, the thing was, even back in the day when you watched the New Editions and all of that, it was a thing to get signed to a major label.
Yeah.
So everything is turning, everything is changing. He had the chance to be like, all right, I'm not going to sign. No one's ever been like, I'm not going to sign. Like, what?
There's a lot you got to put up in order to get a good deal. You know what I mean? It's not just like you just get there on raw talent.
Exactly.
Alone.
Yeah.
Well, like, you got to really
work for it.
See, and the only person who I could really think of who really did it like that from online is Drake. And you see how fast he got cocked up. So that's the only person I know besides Chance who can. Yeah, I don't see that.
I think Chance must got millions already, because he did just turn down a $10 million contract. I said, I might have been a sellout.
That's what you should do. Just take a nice chunk and just walk it home.
But see, if you're Chance, you can go into that meeting and say, this is what I want.
Right.
So, I mean, you know, and it's just. It's Chance.
Oh, and he bought the whole dang on 87 Studio, the movie theater, the other day to see Get Out. I think he can do no wrong in my eyes. He can do no wrong. Absolutely no wrong.
So what
his music can get better, but
Chris Brown did wrong.
He always do wrong, but hey,
Chris Brown slapped. Look, we don't know. This is allegedly.
I'm saying allegedly. Carucci said he beat on her. I rolled my eyes at that only because why are you just not saying that now? I don't like, and I'm saying it's not true, but I don't like when you feel like you have to hold on to information either to protect your end or his end. If he was doing that before, why didn't you feel, I don't know, maybe she didn't want to get him in trouble because it was that whole after the Rihanna incident, but baby, come on. Y'all already broke
y'all
up.
Know what
you
it
got
is.
Your fame.
You guys know what it is. Chris Brown is just like another Bobby Brown. You know what it is. Come on now, man.
I thought he lost it.
Yeah, man.
He lost it.
You know,
I think he's taking an L, too. He ain't going to be the same artist he was either.
No.
He's taking a lot of L's.
I think he's going to be behind the scenes writing and doing a lot of that. Wow. I think.
After. Yeah.
He's
not going to be able to afford to. Yeah, he's not going to be able to afford to do any more
so
tours
he's
and all that.
Working for somebody else is what it's going to be.
If he keep taking these L's.
Chris Brown, man. Chris, y'all y'all sleep on Chris Brown. I'm sorry.
I'm still saying he's a great artist. Chris Brown's a great artist
as well, but I think that
his mouth ain't gonna get him too far.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
See, the thing is, people look at it about the whole Rihanna situation, and I don't condone a man hitting a woman, but Rihanna and some women.
That's a whole nother discussion. Hold on, what I'm saying, that guy's career. Right, you know, she could have just sucked the soul right out of that man.
Right, but
you
what
know?
I'm saying is, like, people label him because of that.
That's
just
true.
Like when he spazzed out on that news show.
I thought that was
the
great.
The lady kept.
Well, that's why any little thing that he does, he's gonna get. You know, exactly. It's gonna be hard.
He's hit, but there's a difference between understanding.
But that's why they'll keep him working. That's why they'll keep him working. They'll keep him behind the scenes making money off of his creative genius. And you know what I mean? He'll probably waste away doing it for the rest of his life.
That's right.
That's probably what's going to end up happening.
See,
because how is he going to redeem himself at this point? You know?
I mean, you really can't because it happened twice.
Mm-hmm.
You really can't. And
well, if you look at him, he looks like he's
well,
just
we don't
broken.
Know. It's allegedly. We don't know. Like I
man,
said,
we
I don't know.
Come on. Karrueche said something to him. And it sent him
but
off.
But now it's a restraining order against him. So, but now no one's speaking about it now. It's gone. Like,
see,
it came up and now it's disappeared.
Accusation, though. Like, if she wanted to get at him, that's the one
she
thing
would.
She could say that everybody would be like, oh, yep.
We knew it. Right.
Exactly,
yeah.
You know?
That so, part. But,
it's
yeah, that, exactly.
Man, that's
exactly.
Crazy, though, man.
Nobody really knows
but
what
see,
happened.
I personally don't think so.
But here's my thing. I don't condone hitting women. I'm putting that out there. But some situations, I understand. Why a man would hit a woman. If a guy paid for a household and the woman cheats in the household that man is paying for, and we're on air, you don't want to say that on it. But I can understand maybe why he would, you know, put his, you know, just you. You know, I understand that. But
choke her out.
Yeah, you know, I mean, but, you know, do I condone it? No, but I understand it. That's right. A different story.
Yeah, like, that's just like, say, for instance, I ain't gonna lie. If I walk in the house and my girl in the bed with another guy.
Huh? We know you're thinking about girl,
that. It's going down.
With another guy? Oh, no. I always said, I kill him and watch her, make her watch it and torture.
Ooh.
See, that sounds like some cynical
sadistic.
Stuff.
Sadistic.
And then guess what? She's gonna be like, "Oh, this dude crazy. I ain't never gonna do that again."
So you would still be with
her? After the
that's
first
a,
time,
that depends.
I wouldn't do it because knowing your head as a man, if you're cheating on me, I can't be with you anymore.
Well,
cause my head gonna be too messed off. I can't be with you.
Well,
I can't.
I don't know. My girl already know I'm crazy, so.
Anything else going on in the news, Ebony?
Sorry, I got thrown off a little. I can't. Speaking of relationships, a video went viral. It's called Hurt Bay. Has anybody ever, y'all heard of it?
No.
Mm-mm.
Oh, my God. We got to pull this up. It is amazing.
Okay.
I mean, it's not amazing. It's very sad, actually. But it was this video of this couple, and she wanted to know why her boyfriend was cheating on her. So
okay.
They sat face-to-face how we are, and
I think I've seen
he discussed... You know, they discuss and she asks him, you know, they started talking like how long they were together, whatever. And she was like, you know, how many times you cheated? And he's like, you know, I don't know. I wasn't keeping count. And she was like, how many girls were there? Just questions. And she was crying. And, you know, it went viral in a matter of 2 minutes. And everyone was talking about it. And it was sad. You know, and now she's, of course, famous just like that. Oh, and Miss Thing, Cash Me Outside, how about that?
I'm tired.
Oh
of that.
My goodness.
She, how about it? She reportedly
muzzle.
Is now charging $30,000 for appearances.
Oh my god!
And it's foolery. Of course, it's foolery. We all know it. It was funny at the moment. I think she got a little 15 minutes of fame.
She's gonna be so humiliated when she gets older and watches herself.
Back.
And she
right, you're only 14 years old.
Exactly.
And
why is
now
she famous?
I feel. Because
of that
Catch Me Out,
yeah,
Dr.
Yeah.
Phil episode, which I didn't even know was old.
Because she's an SHIT show. That's what they want to watch.
That everyone and wants. Social media wants what's hot. Not social media, just everyone in general as a generation wants something what's good and what's trending right now. And thought it was funny. I did think it was funny. I'm not going to lie. That it was kind of entertaining. But now it's to the point where I'm like, okay, wait a second. Who was really paying you in the first place so now you can charge this ridiculous $30,000
amount? Well, that just goes to show, like, that's talent. Like, this woman is culminating all this money off of what? What kind of talent?
Of a black culture being, quote-unquote, ghetto.
Right.
So, because I'm like, I could have did that. I could have definitely came up with that and been ghetto at 14 years old.
Did you ever see the videos where girls were contacting her to fight, and she was just, like, meeting people up on the street?
Meeting people outside.
What is wrong with this girl?
They were dragging her across lawns and smashing her, and she's like, oh, yeah.
And surprisingly, her mom is going along with it, yeah, which her is mom very unfortunate.
She's holding
the
down.
That's how her mother was. Look the way that her mother talks to her. You know what I mean?
But the remix god is amazing. So I'm going to let... shout out to the remix guy, because that is hot. I ain't gonna even lie. That remix he did to that was dope.
I'm done.
He was the guy that did the remix to I Got the Beans, Greens.
And snack. Didn't he get sued for that?
I don't know. That's a good question. I can
you know what?
Up.
It was some allegations of that, but coming to find out, I just seen her perform it, Shirley Caesar. Performance. So I'm like, how in the hell is you suing him?
Because she wanted the cash money.
Man, money is the root of all evil, man.
She wanted the cash money.
Money is
the
root of all evil.
Hey, I need to be charging $30K.
You know who's gonna book her? The same people who booked that dude that Welvin the Great dude, these nuts guy.
Oh yeah, they was booking him for me. I saw him in LA. I ran into
He was in Adriana's. They were booking him. They were booking him like he's a regular rapper.
That's so
Welvin
crazy.
The Great at Adriana's. Be there in Chicago tonight.
That's insane. That is totally insane. Love and Hip Hop Atlanta is coming on next week. Love and Hip Hop New York just went off. Yandy is a liar, but I'm not gonna even go there. Love and Hip Hop Atlanta trailer.
I've seen it. I think
it's gonna be one. I'm gonna have to.
Kirk is having a baby
again. Again, he cheating again, and I just can't. They have who else? Of course, Jocelyn doing a paternity test to see if it's Stevie's baby. And what else is a highlight of? Tommy got out of jail, but she's looking, fighting some girl. I don't even know who she's fighting. Who else was interesting? I think her and Carly Rae get into it all that. I think the new season, Atlanta, is going to be crazy. I think they just got done filming that. So.
Okay. Well, I'm excited.
Hip Hop Atlanta, I think March, whatever next Monday is, March 5th or 6th or 7th or whatever day that is. So.
Charlie, let me ask you this. While we're on this discussing the relationships, are you single?
Sometimes.
I like
that.
Hey, sometimes. I like that. Are you single? Sometimes. It just depends on the day.
I
just depends. When we come back, man, I want to ask you, man, what kind of guys are you into? Are you into those muscular types, or are you more into the guys
into
with
manly
the
manly men?
Manly men.
Manly men.
Like, are we gonna elaborate on that though?
We're gonna come right back, man. We're gonna come right back. Side Town Over Radio is the one and only DJ Malone.
Hey, your girl Ebony Kier.
We're back in Chicago, man. Let's go.
Hey, what's happening? It's Phoenix, and I'm chilling here with DJ Malone, Chicago Fleet DJs.
Hey, this is Miranda with your boy DJ Malone, and we've been live.
Yo, it's the one and only DJ Malone, man, Chi-Town Over Radio, and we... I messed it up, man. I'm kind of out of sync right now. Let's do this again. It's the one and only DJ Malone.
Hey, your girl Ebony. Yeah.
Right. Chi-Town Over Radio, man. Oh, hold on. That's the wrong. I saved it. I need to get the horns. I'm out of
It's okay. You got to get back in a swing.
Yeah, I got to get back into the swing of things. I've been on, not vacation because I was, working, but I've been out of town doing things in Houston. One thing I will say about Houston, I love their barbecue. It's very nice and tasty. What was your favorite part of us being down there for Super Bowl, Ebony?
The Super Bowl.
It was
you
so should
have seen how we watched the Super Bowl. Like, it was like this thing, they have a big old like jumbo screen outside, and like people were like in the lot and like watching. It was dope. It was super dope.
It was. But we were with the Falcons.
I'm still mad. that the Falcons lost. How do you jag a 21 point lead? Like, how do
Brady.
You do that?
Brady.
Forget Tom Brady.
I Brady.
Right. Bye, Tom Brady. Forget yeah. you. Falcons should have won that.
Oh, man. So, well, before we went to the break, we asked Charlie, man, what kind of, you know, is he single? She said sometimes, which I thought it was a great idea. She says she's like manly men. So when you say manly men, are you talking about more of caveman? Are you talking about more of
no, not caveman. More just traditional, you know, male-female role.
Yeah.
The man is the dominant to a certain degree. But, okay. You know, I bring my own things to the table, so... You know,
okay.
It's kind of
appearance-wise, if somebody was to come up to Charlie, how do they? What attracts you?
It's not necessarily always about appearance. Like personality, intelligence, a lot of those things, you know, play into it. I'd rather have somebody that's got a brain than somebody who's just nice to look at. You know,
that's real.
That only lasts for so long. You know.
Yeah, that's mm-hmm. that's real. Now, this day, Raven, I love my sister. I love her to death. Mm-hmm. But she's dating a sissy dude.
Uh-huh.
So, I told Ebony about this, so I'm going to tell you. So she gets this dude or whatever. They've been together for a little bit now. You know, a couple years. I don't know, I guess. I just know they've been together for a minute. So, she hits me up on my line. She said, yo, brother, can you come help me? My tire is on flat. And I don't know what to do. Okay, cool. Mm-hmm. I'm thinking she's just by herself. Mm-hmm. So I get there. And when I get there, it's him and her. And I'm like, so he can't help you? He doesn't know how to fix a tire.
Somebody never taught him.
I don't know
it's
how to
unfortunate.
Do it.
You gotta learn.
Another situation. They went to the movies and a dude kinda, he wasn't like trying to, I guess he was trying to fight him, but it was verbally most of it.
Yeah.
So he was more like, yeah, what you gonna do? What's up? And she said he ran to the car and left her. And
wow. I said he's fired. I said no boyfriend. Right. We're done.
Right.
That would have been the last straw.
So how would you feel in that situation that a guy, he doesn't know to do the traditional manly stuff? If the car breaks down, he doesn't.
Well, I don't do nothing because I ain't got time to fix nobody's BS. You know what I mean? I'm not sticking around to fix it. That's somebody needs to take him aside and play daddy for a day and teach him some manly stuff, I guess.
I don't know. I just...
Or your sister's going to have to learn all those things or something.
I taught both of them. I said, y'all both come here.
She's going to have to be the stay-at-home mommy then.
And I said, y'all both come here and watch me fix this tire. But as a man... If another man's coming to help you out, I'm not AAA or nobody, but if another man's coming to help you out, doesn't that kind of blow your self-esteem as a man?
Yeah. Yeah. Honestly,
I don't know. I'm not a man.
Right.
I can say this, like,
I can change a tire though.
I've been in situations like previously with my girl, like she has one of her male friends, you know, that been growing up for a long time, want to help her out and stuff like that. I'm like, that's not his job. That's my job.
Right.
I'm your man. Like,
most men don't do anything unless they want to, you know.
Like,
who's going to go out of their way?
Right. Like, her, like, remodeling stuff. And now I'm doing that stuff now. I'm teaching myself. I don't know how to do it. I never did it.
Right.
But I watch my father a lot. So it's like, now I'm teaching myself how to do it. I watch YouTube videos myself. That's something a man should do. That's embarrassing if you got to... have somebody else to teach you.
Yeah, definitely.
Just go on YouTube and watch it.
Right, and we'll never know.
DIY.
Yeah. We'll never know. We just think you do it all along.
It's just crazy how in this day of age that men are so different. How just even 10 years ago, how the skinny jeans. I don't feel like a man should wear skinny jeans.
I think, you know, there's kind of like men and especially are kind of being... demasculated.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Like, if you see it in the clothes, you see it in the way that they act, and then we have, like, this thing with the women who are very touchy about certain things, and they want to be a certain way, which kind of scares men, so it's kind of, we're being thrown all these things, which are confusing people, and people aren't getting, they're not getting the right, whatever, like you said, when you went to school, you know? Like, did that make competitive men? No, it just made a bunch of kids that just came and went, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So these boys aren't learning manly skills. And it's, I guess, you know, in this day and age, you have, like you said, you have to go and seek knowledge because nobody's just going to offer it up to you, you know? And it is a shame, but maybe sometimes somebody like you's got to step up and be like, all right, dude, I'll show you how to, you know, I'll show you how to do this. The next time this happens, you ain't got to call me.
I was teaching my nephew, you know, about, because he's six, and I was teaching him. You know, you open the door for a lady and different stuff like that. And then he said, Uncle, why we do that? And he was like, and I said, well, because I was always taught because women are caretakers. They're the ones who gave us birth.
That's why we're equipped with the crazy emotions, because we got to deal with all the crap, you know?
Exactly.
And we just expect you guys to protect us, and you know what I mean?
Exactly.
And the roles are pretty simple. It's really not that bad. But I think all these different ideologies kind of screw with people's heads. You know, women are very far from what they should be right now, and so are men. And I think it's just the confusion, and everybody's just kind of afraid of one another, you know? It's men aren't in a good place, women aren't in a good place, or women are in a better place, but then they're lacking in other areas that they, you know, are supposed to be doing with their life, you know? So.
That's real, Ebony. So, could you date a man like that, Ebony? Like, what if he was willing to learn?
I'm like a damsel in distress. If he's willing to learn, whatever. But I'm more so, I'm literally a damsel. If something happens to me, I'm like freaking out. So, like, if I'm stranded on the side of the road, and either you're with me or you come and act like you're trying to help and you really can't do anything, I'm one, you're going to piss me off. And two, I'm just going to be an emotional wreck. And I'm just going to be like, what did you come here for? Like, I'm a Gemini. So, I really get, like, it. It's a quick switch. Like, don't do nothing to make me angry. Like, just don't. And if you're going to try to come to the rescue and you don't know what you're doing, I'm just going to be like, really? You could have stayed at home for that. I could have called somebody else.
What if he called AAA? Would that kind of make you?
No, I called you. I didn't call. I could have called AAA myself. Yeah. I called you to come and rescue me, and you can't do your job. No. Or unless you're, like, doing something, you're like, well, I can't do that. I can call AAA for you. I mean, it just kind of depends.
Okay.
But, no. And I do agree with Charlie. I think we have a lot of roles that kind of get all
mixed
into one
and
kind
then,
of thing.
You know, people want things, but they don't want to put in the work. You know what I mean? They don't want to put in what it takes. It's like the man's got to play the man role and the woman's got to play the woman role.
Yeah.
And if the woman wants to play the man role, it's not going to work with the man. And vice versa, you know? We need to go back to the basics, I think.
A lot of young boys, though, I think it comes back to the home, too. A lot of people are growing up fatherless.
Growing up with only women.
But I'm not even saying that that's a, you know, that's a bad thing, but I think young boys, I mean, as far as girls, because I know I grew up with a fatherless dad, no need to go into personal, but I had my mom and I had another father figure in my life also, but I think for young men, that's different, and that do something and take a toll on them. A woman can't teach a man everything.
Exactly. That's why you need both parents in the home.
Exactly.
Because they complement each other.
Exactly.
In every single way. That's why things work. They can work together. It's just people gotta be willing to compromise, you know?
Right.
I guess so. I get scared for our youth because I don't know what's gonna happen.
That's all aspects, I think. I'm not